Welcome to Integration Made Easy, a video series brought to you by Miracle's Integration Center of Excellence team.
Hi everyone, this is Kirani Nelluri from EduPractice working as API developer. This presentation is all about deployment automation of product lifecycle using API Connect CLI commands with Jenkins and GitLab. Here are the topics I'm going to cover in this video: API Connect overview, product and API lifecycle, and what is the Jenkins and how we make automation using this Jenkins and architecture flow, and followed by the live demo about deployment on API Connect through Jenkins. This is API Connect overview. IBM API Connect is an integrated API management offering with API lifecycle capabilities. APIC allows the users to create, run, manage, and secure the APIs, both on on-premises and cloud environments. It provides the automated visual and coding options for creating APIs and products, and it also provides advanced API usage analytics to visualize the API log data, and by using this analytical data, we can export this data to third parties also. And it also provides customizable self-service developer portal for publishing APIs to provide access to the third parties. Here, the consumers like external app developers and partner app developers, internal app developers can access these published APIs in developer portal. In API Connect, we can create and create the APIs and products using developer toolkit locally, and also we can create them in Vumix, which is a cloud environment. And coming to Jenkins, Jenkins is one of the Java-based most powerful continuous integration tools with more than number of plugins. By using these plugins, we can make integration with different tools, and it can also use it to build and test the software continuously and make it easier for the developer. And coming to architecture flow, and here we have GitLab, Jenkins, and API Connect. Here, the Git may be GitLab, Git repository may be GitLab, GitBash, or GitHub, anything. Here, this is the Jenkins, and this is the workspace in Jenkins. And here we are using the Git and Node plugin here in Jenkins. And this is the API Connect prod catalog, and this is the API Connect non-prod catalog. Whenever a developer pushes the ML definition files of the product and the API in GitLab, automatically the job we configured in the Jenkins will be triggered and the changes will be reflected in the API Connect. And now we will have a quick demo about deployment on API Connect to Jenkins. Here I am using API Manager, which was installed locally in my machine to showcase the APIs and products. In order to access the APIs and products, we need to log in with your credentials. This is the dashboard of the API Manager. Here we have a number of API Connect organizations. Now I am going to POC organization. These are the products and the APIs which we created earlier. So among all these APIs and products, I want to publish one of the products from POC organization to automation organization using Jenkins. For this, I need to download the definition files of the product and API which I want to publish. So go to the product and select the product which you want to publish, and go here and click on download. The product file will be downloaded. Similarly for API also, go to API which you want to publish and then click on download. These API and product files will be downloaded locally. Then go to GitLab which was installed in your system. Log in with your credentials. This is GitLab dashboard. If you want to create the new project, just click on new project here, and it will ask for the project name and give the project name and create a project. But here I have created the project for this demo earlier. This is my project, and here are the YAML files which I was downloaded earlier. This is the product YAML file and this is the API YAML file. And here I need to configure the webhook in settings. For that, go to settings and then integrations. Here it will ask for the webhook. This webhook allows you to trigger the URL which you want to trigger. Here I am providing Jenkins URL. So this is the Jenkins URL. So once go to browser and open Jenkins. Login with your credentials again. Here this is a Jenkins dashboard. If you want to create a new job here, just click on new item and provide your job name and select the freestyle project. Then click on OK. The project will be created. But here I have created the project earlier and my project name is APIC Deployment Automation Non-Prod. And here click on configure in order to configure your job. Go to source code management. Here select the Git option. Whenever you select the Git option, it will ask for the Git repository URL. So provide the GitLab URL, this URL with .git extension and followed by the GitLab credentials you want. And then come to build triggers. Select the build when a change is pushed to the GitLab. If you select this, whenever a change is done in GitLab, the change will be reflected in this. And select the provide node and npm bin folder to the path in build environment session. And select the APIC Node.js installation. This APIC contain Node.js plugins and packages. And in build session, select the add build step and select the execute shell. Whenever you select the execute shell, the console will open like this. Here provide the API CLI commands which you want to perform. So this execute shell will execute the APIC CLI commands. This first command is in order to log into the server, 159 server. This is, and here you need to provide the username and password for the server and followed by the command in order to push the product YAML files, JWT API product YAML files from GitLab to the Jenkins. You need to write this command, push command, and then publish command. Then you need to log out from the server and save the job. After completion of the job creation, just go to GitLab and then your project. Just make any change in readme file or in product or API YAML file and commit the changes. Here you can find the job is triggered automatically. Once if you click on this ball, the console output will be shown here. Here you can view the execution of your API CLI commands. And finally you can get a message like success. Here this is the command to log into the server and it is showing successfully log into the server and then push command and then publish command and log out from the server and the task is complete, finished successfully. Then go to API manager and change the organization to automation. Here in API, you will find the JWT API which I have published from POC organization to automation organization using Jenkins. And same for product also. So this way we can publish the APIs from lower environment to higher environment. And for higher environments like prod, the process of product lifecycle will change. There you need to provide all the product lifecycle steps like deprecate, retire and all. For that I have created another project like APIC deployment automation prod. Go to configure and directly go to execute shell. Here I have written API product lifecycle steps like deprecate, retire and delete. And save the file. And same for this, same applied for this prod environment also. Thank you.
Thank you for watching a video on Integration Made Easy, a video series brought to you by Miracles Integration Center of Excellence. For more information about this playlist and for more videos, please visit www.miraclesoft.com/IME.